I was just not good at StarCraft.
Yeah.
I was great at Sims.
Wow.
Yeah.
Have I told this
building
story?
Building civilizations.
I've told you the Sims story, right?
No.
About like how… I've never told this story? I think I have. No. Diane, I've never talked about Sims here?
I had no idea you even knew what Sims was.
Okay, so Mithra is a huge gamer. And when back in the day, like he was playing Sims and we… I swear to God I told this story.
No.
Just go, bro.
Okay, so we were sharing a small apartment. Nothing ringing your bells?
No.
We were sharing like a very tiny one room together where we only had one bed and one desk.
You told us about like how it was tough and you guys drink and Baileys.
We had to take turns playing using the computer because we only had one computer. So when he would sleep, I would wake up and use the computer. When I would sleep, he would wake up and use the computer. So we did a timeshare on our own computer because we were so like honestly like poor. Okay. And so he was playing Sims and he was trying to get me to play. So, but we would have to take turns playing and we were on the same map. I really didn't tell this story.
No.
Just go, bro.
What?
You only talked about living with him and drinking Baileys on hot days.
So on Sims, you can have two houses in the same map. So like a connected universe basically, right? So I would wake up and build my house and like, you know, have my Sims like… On a Dance Dance Revolution thing in there and like some couches, like all these things and a pool. And then I would look over at Mithra's map and Mithra's like building a better place. Like the place looks even better than mine, right? So I'd be like, oh, I gotta work on this later. And I go to sleep. He wakes up, he's checking mine out. He's like, oh, I'm gonna outdo this guy. So he's building his again, building it up. It looks great. And then I wake up and what I do is I go into his account. I send his sim over to my sim. Make them fall in love. Okay? And then I make his sim take a dip in my swimming pool. And as his sim is swimming in my swimming… Okay, this… Do not do this.
This is a, crazy story.
This is like… Just something that happened between two rappers, okay? So I would make his sim swim inside my swimming pool. And as the sim is swimming, I would take away the ladder. I would delete the ladder.
Yeah.
So the sim won't be able to escape the swimming pool.
Yeah.
Eventually
drowns.
Becomes a tombstone in my backyard.
It's really dark.
It is really dark. I didn't mean for this to go this way.
Yeah.
Okay. But we were kids. Okay. And the competition got heavy. Okay.
Dude.
Okay. And then… And also realize like… I'm like living nocturnally right now to play this game. I go back to sleep. Mithra wakes up. Checks out… Figures out that his sim is… He's dead.
Julie.
Yeah.
Julie is passed.
And then goes to my map and sees a tombstone there. So what can he do? Right? So he builds another situation where he… Now my sim is now a tombstone on his backyard. Okay? We're going back and forth growing these numbers of tombstones. It was really dark.
That is really dark.
It is really dark, but it happened.
And it's crazy that y'all have never talked about this.
This was before, right before Epikai's first album came out. Okay, when we were struggling together. And I think we were really stressed. Like I told you, we didn't have air conditioning.
Right.
Okay. Like we were like living off nothing. Okay, we were time sharing a computer. Come on.
Right.
Right? And this Sims thing was the only thing where we could like… Actually, like have a nice house and stuff.
Right.
So things got kind of dark, right? And eventually, what happened was, I realized what I was doing, like what I had created, like what we were doing to each other, and it just made me feel so disgusted, because I would look in my backyard now, and there would be like 30 tombstones.
Right.
And you know, like you can see ghosts.
In Sims?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, sometimes they appear as spirits. And I see the spirits of past Mithra Sims.
Julie.
And I'm like, oh my God, that's Tim. That's Tim from 2 weeks ago. And I felt so disgusted that I destroyed my house. And in the morning, and I went to sleep. Mithra woke up, saw that I had destroyed my own place. And instead of feeling like, you know, the way I did and realizing what we had done, he celebrated. He was like, he won.
Threw a party?
Yeah, he was happy that he won. And I regret that things got that intense and dark, okay? So if anybody's like judging me right now, like on Discord, like, dude, Tablo, I don't like this dude. Yeah. Like, I mean, I know it's a game, but isn't that okay? I was like 21.
Yeah.
Okay. Things were not working out for me. Okay, and I grew beyond that. Right. I've never played Sims again. Okay, so just get off me here.
And for those of you who don't know what Sims is, it's short for simulation. Right?
Yo, just stop.
Thank you.
Right? Stop explaining.
Wait, it is, right?
Yes.
Okay. Dude, you don't look at my face. Do I look surprised? Because I'm not.
Because you did stuff like that?
Dude, Roller Coaster Tycoon.
You can do that?
Dude, you know how like, you know, everything's about your carnival or your amusement park.
Uh-huh.
And man, it's so crazy. It's really helped me become the businessman that I am. Customer service is key, right?
Well, what happened?
What I mean is, you want as many bodies coming through your carnival as often as possible. More revenue.
To make profit.
To make profit. Because I'm building like all sorts of roller coasters.
Yeah.
Nice like donut shops. All sorts of
wheel.
Yeah. A lot of bathrooms. Trash bins. Because like, a lot of people throw up after like the intense ride I built.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They'll throw up. And you can click on somebody. Let's say her name is Jody.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I click on Jody. I could see her happiness levels. Of like, is she amused?
Oh,
she
kind of just like Sims.
Yeah, is she bored?
Okay.
But I don't have any attachment to them except that I need her money, right? And I need her to stay. And I need her to tell her friends back home to come to Amusement Park Ed Nam 100.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? So…
What? You called yourself Ed Nam 100?
The amusement park. So…
Well, that's
but I remember occasionally…
Self-serving name to have for an amusement park.
That was just an example. Dude… But occasionally Jody, no matter what I did, because you could see her thoughts. She was like, oh, I wish there was like Panda Express.
Oh, so she's complaining.
I would make her a Panda Express. And she would be sitting on the bench. She's like, oh, my feet hurt. I would build her a bench right there. I'm
and
like, dude.
And she'd still complain?
And then she would get up and she's like, I want Chinese food. I'm like, yo, Jody, here's a Panda Express right now in real time. I am giving you what you need. I'm giving you what you need. She's like, I'm nauseous. Oh, here's a trash bin. Here's a little paper bag to throw up in. Like, what else do you need? Everything's too far apart. I adjust the park. Everything is around her.
Wait, there are other characters too, right?
No. Yeah, but
why were you so focused on Jody though?
Because
she kept complaining.
She's complaining, but like it's like you say, 99 great comments, one bad comment.
I'm really
like,
sorry, but your Jody needs to take a dip in my pool,
dude. That's what I'm saying. So what I would do is I'm like 8 years old and I'm doing everything I can to make Jody happy. And I'm like, okay, there's nothing that we can do about Jody. So I would build a pool.
Mm-hmm.
Just like a, you know, everything's in squares.
Oh, you did the same thing.
I would just build a pool and then I would pick her up with the master claw. I'd pick up Jody by the shirt.
Oh, God. Okay, this is a game we're talking about. Okay.
Right into the thing.
Okay,
and then
that's pretty dark.
It's dark, but here's the thing.
Way darker than what
here's
I did.
Here's the problem with Roller Coaster Tycoon. There are no repercussions for that. There was no like Jody's missing flyers. There's no like police.
There's no tombstone,
dude. Nothing. No trace of it. So I'm like, why do I need to make any of these people happy? But I guess the only consequence, the reason why you wouldn't do that, is because Jody still has money. She's still paying for things, right? Park admission, Panda Express.
Uh-huh.
But when I get rid of her, she's not spending so much. So like, that's when I was like, this person's unhappy. Boom, 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 boom. But I told you like, I'm trying to make Jody happy so she tells her friends. But if she doesn't exist anymore, she can't tell her friends.
Okay, this is getting way too dark. Okay, so you know the whole like thing about gaming?
Yeah.
Like people saying that like games like, you know, create real life monsters. You know, that whole debate?
Yeah.
I always never knew what to think about that because like, you know, I don't believe that we should be blaming films and games. I believe that like we need to do better as parents and teachers to like, we need to not shift the blame. But when I hear stories like this, and I told half the story too, right? Like that was my story. So I don't know.
But you turned out all right.
Yeah, I would never, you know, I would never build a pool.
Right. I don't feel like that at all outside of Roller Coaster Tycoon. And let's be honest, like she had it coming.
You are listening to the Tablo podcast.